Hello everyone, welcome to part 85 of SQL for Beginner series. In this video session, I am going to explain about ODBC. So in this video session, I am going to explain about ODBC. ODBC stands for Object Database Connectivity. Okay, ODBC stands for Object Database Connectivity. So before I explain what is ODBC, okay, we have to understand what is JDBC. Okay, I already explained what is JDBC in the previous video session. So let me explain it again at a high level. Let's say there are some Java programs. Let's say this is a set of Java code. Some Java code is written here. These are the lines of code in Java. Okay, if you are writing the Java code in such a way that using this Java code, you are trying to make a connection to a, database in MySQL server. Okay. So by writing some Java program, using that Java program, if you are connecting to a database in a MySQL server, okay, this concept is known as JDBC. What is JDBC? Connecting to a database in MySQL server from the Java programs. Okay. How it is possible? With the help of JDBC only it is possible. Okay. Without JDBC, you cannot connect to a database in MySQL server from the Java program. These are Java programs. Okay. Let's say this is Java code. You have written some Java code here. And if you want this particular Java code to connect to the database in MySQL server, then we need JDBC. Okay. Without JDBC, we cannot do this connection. This concept is known as Java Database Connectivity. JDBC stands for Java Database Connectivity. Fine. And this connection is possible with the help of JDBC driver. There is something known as JDBC driver. Okay. So we have to write some Java code and we need to configure this Java project with this JDBC driver. Okay. JDBC driver. Then only we can write the code in such a way that it can connect to this database in MySQL server. Okay. Without JDBC driver, we cannot connect to the database in MySQL server from the Java programs. And all this concept together is known as JDBC. JDBC uses JDBC driver for making the Java code connect to the database in the MySQL server. Now guys, in this video session, our focus is on ODBC, not JDBC, okay? So it's ODBC. Why we need ODBC, guys? Okay, we have JDBC, right? But what is the requirement for using the ODBC? Let me explain that. So till the previous videos, we have used MySQL Workbench client, right? We have used MySQL Workbench client for what? This is MySQL Workbench client, guys. Okay. MySQL Workbench client. This is a client, and using this client, from this client, we can connect to the database. That is MySQL server. We can connect. From this MySQL Workbench client, we can connect to the MySQL server. Okay, MySQL server we can connect. So here, MySQL server, which is installed in my local machine, that's my local host, and it's running in 3306 port number in my machine itself. And then its username for connecting to this MySQL server is root, and again password is also root. So if I say okay, from this MySQL Workbench client will make a connection to the MySQL server. Okay, all the databases which are available in this MySQL server are displayed here. What are the databases that are there in this MySQL server? We have QFox, we have Scylla, we have Sys, and we have Word. Okay, in this one of the database, that is QFox database, I created this QFox database in one of the previous videos. Okay, but coming to the other databases, that is Scylla, Sys, Word. Okay, this came by default when I installed MySQL server in my machine. Okay, so these databases are by default. Okay, they are like by default available in this MySQL server, but coming to QFox, I created my own. Okay, I created this QFox database. So there are four databases inside this MySQL server, and in order to connect to this MySQL server, we need MySQL Workbench, right? Using MySQL Workbench, we can connect to all the databases that are available in the MySQL server. Okay. So here in our example, we have four databases. One I created by me, and remaining three came from the by default with the MySQL server. Okay. Fine. So now, guys, MySQL Workbench client to connect to the all databases that are available in the MySQL server. Fine. So here, why we are connecting? Why the MySQL Workbench client is connecting to the MySQL server? Okay. Why the MySQL Workbench client is connecting to the MySQL server? For what purpose the MySQL client is connecting to the MySQL server? The purpose is to access the databases. Okay, here MySQL server has a list of databases. One database created by me and remaining came by default in the MySQL server. So in order to connect to this existing four databases which are there in MySQL server, we have to connect to this MySQL server by using the MySQL Workbench. That's the purpose of MySQL Workbench client. The purpose of the MySQL Workbench client is to connect to the MySQL server having this databases. Okay, that's fine. So we can access the, if you connect to the MySQL server using the MySQL Workbench client, we can access this databases. Why we need to access this databases? So if we can access the databases, then we can create the tables, delete the tables, alter the tables, update the tables. We can do all the operations around the tables and all the things under the database we can perform. Okay. So here MySQL Workbench client is connecting to the MySQL server for accessing the databases so that we can perform operations on the different things that are there in the databases, like tables are there, okay, a lot of stuff, indexes are there, views are there, like the many things are there in the databases. To perform operations on all those things, okay, we need this MySQL Workbench client to connect to this database in the MySQL server. Anyhow, just for this MySQL Workbench client to connect to this thing, databases in the MySQL server, we need things, right? That is, we need IP address of the IP address of the MySQL server. Since MySQL server is installed in my machine, you don't have to provide the IP address. Localhost will be fine. Okay. Then this MySQL will be generally by default running on the 3306 port number in my machine. So localhost 3306, and some username and password will be required for connecting to this, okay, MySQL server. So as explained in previous videos, when I installed this MySQL server, I gave the username and password for the MySQL server as root and root. Okay. Both are root only, username, password. So with these details, MySQL Workbench client can connect to the all the data and connect to the MySQL server and access all the databases that are there inside this MySQL server. So far so good, guys. Okay, so far so good. Now we understood what is the importance of MySQL Workbench client. Okay, now this MySQL Workbench client, in order to make this connection to this MySQL server internally, MySQL Workbench client, okay, this is a tool, guys. Not the MySQL Workbench client tool, right? Okay, this tool internally uses a driver, that is JDBC driver only. Okay, here JDBC driver is not only required for the Java programs to connect to the MySQL server, but also the JDBC driver is used by this MySQL Workbench client internally, guys. You don't have to specifically specify. Okay, you don't have to download this, or in case of MySQL Workbench client, so you don't have to download this driver. Automatically, internally, this MySQL Workbench client will have this JDBC driver. It internally uses this driver to make a connection to the MySQL server in order to access all the databases that are there in the MySQL server. Okay, here internally JDBC driver is being used by this client tool. But coming to other tools, there are some other tools also, guys. There's a tool like SQL, ODBC, okay, connectivity, okay, tool. Okay, so what is that tool? ODBC, SQL ODBC query client tool. Okay, query tool, guys. Okay, this is query. Okay, SQL ODBC client, okay, query client tool. So here, so far I have connected to the MySQL server using the MySQL Workbench client, but now I am saying that if we have to connect to the same MySQL, okay, if you have to access the databases by connecting to the MySQL server. Okay, if you have to access the databases by connecting to the MySQL server, okay, via this SQL ODBC query tool. This query tool is an alternative for this MySQL Workbench client tool. Okay, earlier, till the previous videos, I have used MySQL Workbench client tool. So we can also use another type of tool, guys. In place of this MySQL Workbench, we can use SQL ODBC query client tool. Okay, SQL ODBC query client tool also we can use. But guys, for the SQL ODBC query client tool to connect to this databases in the MySQL server, this client tool requires a different driver. Here JDBC driver is internally used by this client tool, Workbench client tool, but coming to SQL ODBC query client tool, JDBC is not used. Okay, JDBC driver is not used. Instead, ODBC driver will be used. Okay, instead ODBC driver will be used. Fine. So now you understood, right, why we have to learn ODBC. ODBC stands for object database connectivity, and here we have ODBC driver. Okay, object database connectivity driver, and this driver is required when we are using SQL ODBC query client tool in place of this, okay, instead of this MySQL Workbench client tool. Okay, instead of MySQL Workbench client tool, if you are using SQL ODBC query client tool, we need ODBC driver for connecting to the MySQL server for accessing the databases. So in this video session, I am going to explain about ODBC. Okay, and in order to explain about ODBC, I have to explain about this SQL ODBC query client tool and how this client tool connects to this MySQL server database via this ODBC driver. Okay, so all these things I am going to explain in this video. Our focus is on ODBC now. Okay, I am going to explain about ODBC, SQL ODBC query client tool, this ODBC driver, and how it can connect to this MySQL server database. Okay, fine. So let me practically show you all the things. So the first step here is we need to type ODBC here. Okay, already ODBC is there. Okay, I thought like ODBC has to be installed and downloaded here, but already ODBC is there in my machine. As you can see, you are getting this option. When I type ODBC in this Windows search text box field, I am getting this ODBC data sources 64-bit. Select this. Okay, select this. How can I get this ODBC by default, guys? Okay, how the ODBC has entered into my machine by default? The thing here is when you have installed, okay, when you have installed MySQL software, okay, DBMS software. In one of the previous videos, I explained how to install and configure MySQL software, right? When you install the software, this software came with all the default drivers and all the stuff. So as part of that, ODBC also came by default. Okay, ODBC is also installed by default, guys. Okay, when you install MySQL software, automatically this ODBC also got installed. So now go to the drivers tab. Under this, you should see these two things, guys. Okay, we need these two things in order to make the connection to this MySQL server via this this SQL ODBC query client tool. Okay, using this SQL ODBC query client tool, if you want to make a connection to the databases in the MySQL server, okay, then we need ODBC driver. So this ODBC driver is nothing but available here. I have not installed or configured, right? Automatically it is there. How it came automatically in this my machine? Because when I install MySQL software, okay, MySQL RDBMS software, automatically this software installed this ODBC related stuff. Okay, so when you type ODBC here, you will get this, and then under the driver tab, as you can see, these two drivers are there. Okay, ODBC drivers are already there. For example, let's say you have not installed MySQL software. And this particular ODBC is not available for you. Okay, this particular ODBC is not available for you. In that case, what you will do? Since I installed MySQL software in one of the previous videos, I got this ODBC options. But if ODBC is not installed in your machine, what we have to do? We have to follow some steps, guys. Okay, so open Google, search for MySQL, okay, connectors, MySQL connectors. Just search for MySQL connectors, you will get this link, guys. products connector. This particular URL you will get. Just click on this, it will take you to a particular page, and here MySQL connectors are there. And as you can see, the first one, this is not related one. As you can see, the second one, ODBC driver for MySQL is there. You have to download this driver. Okay, all these things you have to do. Okay, you have to download this if it is not available here. If I say ODBC here, it's directly coming, and if I select drivers, I can see the drivers, this ANSI driver and Unicode driver of the MySQL ODBC already there. But if these things are not there for you, if your system doesn't have the MySQL installed, then you have to manually go to this mysql.com products connector. Then here ODBC driver for MySQL is there. Just click on this download. Okay, you have to download it. No problem, guys. We can install. Okay, even though it is available, we can install also. So if you don't have that ODBC in your machine, you have to install from this particular place. You have to download and install the ODBC from this place. ODBC driver should be installed from this place. So here MySQL community downloads and connector ODBC is there. Scroll down and we have to go with this Windows 64-bit MSI installer. Download this. Okay, download this. So it's around the 14 MB or something. So 14 MB or something. And here it is asking you to log in. Click on login, guys. Click on login. So you should have an Oracle account, guys. Okay, not to download this particular ODBC, you need to have the Oracle account. So if you don't have, you can create an account from here. Create account. You can see an option here, create account. If you have the account, I already have the account details, guys. So I will directly give the account details. arun.moturi@gmail.com. And here I will give my password. Click on sign in. So I got logged into my Oracle account and the ODBC driver should be downloaded now. Okay, begin your download. Some download now. MySQL connector for ODBC, Windows 64-bit. Okay, you have to download this. Click on this. The driver will be downloaded. Okay. So now we have to download this and install it, guys. Okay. You have to download and install this. So it's taking some time. Already I downloaded, guys. As you can see here, this MySQL connector ODBC is already there. I don't have to download again. So let me cancel this. Okay. So it's already there in my downloads folder. So if you don't have this, you can download this. Okay. So you just double click on this MySQL connector ODBC and click on next. So some options are coming. Click on next. So MySQL, since it is already there, since ODBC is already there in my machine, I'm getting modify. In case of you will not get this modify, repair, remove. Okay. You may get the installation wizard only. So here I will select to modify. Okay. Just to make sure that we'll go with the next steps. So click on next. Okay. So sometimes it will take some time, guys. So next, back. Okay. So if I say modify, right, it's not going for, it's going now. Okay. Some problem is there. That's fine. I'm just going and installing. So let's say if you don't have ODBC, this is a process. Like you have to install the ODBC driver using the default options. So ODBC got installed now. Okay. ODBC driver got installed in your machine. Just to confirm that again, you can go to the same ODBC and select this ODBC data sources. Go to the drivers. You should see this ANSI driver and Unicode driver. Okay. By default, if you don't have this ANSI driver and Unicode driver, you have to download this MySQL connector ODBC for Windows 64-bit. Since my machine is Windows 64-bit, I downloaded this version. Okay, and install this so that you will get these options. Okay, if not available, you have to install this and you will get these options under the drivers tab of ODBC. Fine. Next thing is, we have to create a data source. Okay, we have to create a data source. For that, what we have to do? We have to create a data source. Third step is after downloading and installing MySQL ODBC driver, and if you find this ANSI driver and Unicode driver in the drivers tab of that ODBC, then up to here it is completed. Fine. Then we have to create the data source name. Creating the data source name. Why we have to create, I will explain later. So for that, just select this system DSN. Okay, system data source. Okay, we have to create the data source name here. Select this MySQL connector ODBC. Or these are existing ones, guys. Okay, you can remove them. Okay, because I was working with this ODBC from long time, so these options came. You can remove them. Okay, so we have to freshly create one. So now we don't have anything. Okay, under system DSN, we don't have any data source. Here we have to create the data source. Okay, we have to create the data source. You'll understand what is data source now after I create. So data source, now there is no database. Click on add. And you will get this kind of dialogue saying create new data source, MySQL. You have to select this ANSI driver, okay? MySQL ODBC ANSI driver and click on finish. This MySQL connector ODBC will come, dialogue will come. Here, give some name, guys. Let's say I would like to connect to QFox database, okay? QFox database in MySQL connect, okay? Connecting. So connector. So QFox database in MySQL, QFox DB. In MySQL server connector, some name I am giving for this data source. Okay, So because I would like to connect to QFox database in MySQL server. Okay, so that's why I'm giving QFox here. There are four databases in MySQL server, right? I showed you. So in that, I would like to connect to the one of the database, that is QFox. So I'm giving this data source name as QFox DB MySQL connector. Okay, so here you have to give the local host. Okay, IP address of the MySQL server is, MySQL server is installed in my machine only in, as part of the previous videos. Okay, I explained how to install. So local host, here port number will be 3306. And here username is root. MySQL server username is root. And password is also root, as I explained. Here, since I would like to connect, access this QFox database in this MySQL server, so the list of databases will be displayed here in the MySQL server, whatever that is installed in my machine. There are this many databases. Okay, so I want to select, I want to access this QFox database. So I'm selecting the QFox. And after providing all these details, you have to find out whether you can connect to this QFox database in the MySQL server or not. For doing that, you just click on the test. If you get connection successful, that means you are able to connect to the database. Okay, MySQL server QFox database, you are able to access and connect. Okay, click on OK. And you see the data source got created with the name QFox DB MySQL connector. Click on OK. Done. Okay, so we have downloaded and installed MySQL ODBC driver. After that, what we did, we created the data source name. Okay, and in the data source name, I mentioned that I am going to access the QFox database in the MySQL server. I provided all the username and password. You don't have to give username and password again. Okay, already the data source name has that thing. Now we need to have, similar to this MySQL workbench, I told you, right? We have this SQL ODBC query tool. Here I was explaining, right? Using MySQL workbench client, which uses JDBC driver for accessing this database by connecting to the MySQL server. Here we are going to use another tool, that is SQL ODBC query client tool, which needs ODBC driver. So already set up the ODBC driver. I already downloaded and installed the ODBC driver. And also I created a data source. Second thing is we need to create data source. Okay. So in data source, what I provided, I provided the IP of the MySQL server. Since it's my machine, I mentioned the localhost and the port number and the database that I want to access from the MySQL server using this client tool. Okay. ODBC query client tool. Whatever the database I want to access, I provided that. So after providing all this stuff, okay, after providing this, all this stuff, okay, so now this client tool can access this database in the MySQL server. So for that, we need to download and install this query tool, right? We don't have this query client tool, okay? This one we have to download and install. So how to download and install this SQL ODBC query client tool? So again, Google, guys, for everything, Google is there. So SQL, type SQL ODBC query tool. Just search for this. You will get a lot of links, guys. I preferably select this download.cnet.com. So SQL query client tool, click on this. So yes, this is the URL. This is the page where you have to go. And then click on this download now. SQL query client tool using ODBC will start downloading. So thank you for downloading. It started downloading, guys. Already I downloaded, guys. So you don't have to download again. You see, this is downloaded already. So I will simply cancel it, guys. Okay. I don't want duplicate. So I'll cancel it. So this client tool software is downloaded already. You can install it. Okay. Now let's install the query client tool. Welcome to the query tool, SQL query tool. Using ODBC, we have to connect. This tool uses ODBC driver and ODBC data source. Okay. Data source for connecting to the MySQL server, whereas Workbench internally uses JDBC to connect to the MySQL server. You don't have to configure JDBC here in case of Workbench, but in case of the OD, this in case of this SQL query tool of ODBC, we need ODBC to be installed, right? I have manually downloaded and installed the ODBC in my machine. Fine. So then next thing is. Here we have this next option. Click on the next. I agree. Click on next. Then the place where it's, just click on next, guys. You don't have to change anything. Click on next. Installing query tool. So we just have to install this query tool, guys. This is like a workbench only. So where you can create the where you can write the SQL statements and run. Okay. Where you can write the SQL statements and execute them from this tool also. Similar to workbench, we can write the SQL statements and run on the databases of the MySQL server. So it's being installed. It will take a bit time. So So let it complete the installation part. So I got a user access control. I just selected yes, guys. After that, the installation started. So it will. As part of security, you will get a kind of yes or no kind of thing, user access control. So you need to allow this software to be installed in your machine. So when you say yes, it will be installed. Now it has to complete this progress. Let's wait for it to complete. Okay, so the installation has been completed. You just need to click on the close button. So once the close button has been clicked, the SQL ODBC query tool has been installed in your machine. So where you can find it? Maybe on your desktop, you will see this kind of shortcut created. Okay, this kind of SQL ODBC query tool shortcut will be created. Shortcut I. Okay, shortcut. So you just need to double click here. You will get this kind of dialog when you open. Select this machine data source, and in this you should find this source. Okay, that is a data source. We created this data source name, right? If you remember in the last step, I created this QFox DB for connecting to the QFox DB, which is available in the MySQL server. Okay, I gave this name while creating the data source. While creating the data source in the previous step, I created this name. Okay, this data source got created in the previous step. Fine. So this should come here. You have to select this. Now, using this data source, right? You are approving this query tool to connect to the MySQL server, and it should allow you to access the QFox database in the MySQL server. Okay, that's the purpose of the data source. Okay, that's why we have to, after installing the ODBC driver, you have to create the data source like this. Okay, for whatever the database you want to connect, you have to give some name and specify the database and the server and server access details and all the stuff, username, password, everything to create the data source. And when you are using this query tool, it will ask you to select this kind of data source. So you have to select the machine data source tab here and select this QFox DB MySQL connector and say okay. Now you say it got connected to the MySQL server. In that, we will be able to access the QFox database. So in the QFox database, as you already know, EMP1 table is already there, right? Here you see in the MySQL workbench, there are 4 DBs, and via this SQL ODBC query tool, okay, we are able to access only one table. So let's confirm this particular table belongs to which DB. So if you expand here, you can find it out. Under QFox, we have EMP1, okay? So EMP1 table belongs to QFox database. Here, that means using the SQL, okay, ODBC client tool, okay, query client tool, we are able to connect to the QFox database in the MySQL server. Now, why we have to connect to this database, QFox database, so that we can perform operations on the things, objects of this database. So let's say EMP1 is one of the table of this QFox database. This is an object of the QFox database. You can perform operations on this table. So how to do that? We can write some queries like select star from EMP1 table name, okay? Select star from EMP1, select this right click and say execute. So when I run this, you see all the records that are available in the EMP1 table got displayed here. Okay, so guys, this is how we have to use SQL ODBC query client tool for connecting to the MySQL server databases. Okay, via the which driver? ODBC driver. Okay, via ODBC driver. So now tomorrow, let's say you can perform any operations, guys. Not only this one, you can insert the records into the table. Okay, all those things you can do. Okay, all the things that you can do here with the SQL statements, you can write any type of SQL statements on this table. Okay, you can perform here. That's fine. Now I want to connect to a different database. Here QFS database I connected, right? Now this time I would like to connect to another database. For that, what I will do is I have to create a data source, right? ODBC, I have to say, click this and system DSN. And you see this particular data source is created for you to connect to this QFox database, right? QFox database in MySQL server. Now I'm going to create one more. Here again, ANSI driver you have to select, say finish. This time, which database? Let's say here we have 4 databases, right? Let's connect to world database, okay? In world database, what tables we have? We have city, country, all these tables are there. Okay? So here I am saying world database, world DB, okay? MySQL connector. Now here localhost you have to say, because why I'm saying localhost? Because MySQL server is installed in my machine, so I have to say localhost. If MySQL server is at a remote machine, you have to provide the IP address of that particular machine. Okay, and the port number will be generally 3306 only. Okay, here username of that MySQL server is root. Password for connecting to that MySQL server is also root. Now here database, while selecting the database, you have to select this world. Okay, so world database which is there in the MySQL server installed in my machine. Click on test. Connection is successful. Say okay. Now, from this SQL ODBC query client tool. Now current selection is QFox database. You are accessing the QFox database. Now, if you want to connect to another database, file, say new, say query with current connection. Okay, select this. Wait a minute. Say new query. This one. Okay, query with new connection. This option you have to select, not current. New connection you have to say. Say new query with new connection. Say data sources. So from the data sources, what are the different data? So you have to go to this machine data source, and this time you have to select another data source. So if you want to work on this world database, you have to select this database data source. Okay. So if you want to work with QFox database, you have to select this data source. Now I would like to work with the world database. Okay, in the MySQL server. So I am selecting this data source and saying okay. It got changed. So what are the tables available now? You see, there are more tables now in the world database of MySQL server. We have city, country language, and other tables are there. Similarly, if you want to connect to other database, here we have secular database. If you want to connect to secular database tables, what you want to do? What you have to do, guys? You have to create another data source. Okay, this is the same process for everything. Okay, go to system DSN. So existing data sources are these two data sources. Click on add, select ANSI driver, click on finish. Here say Sakila DB in MySQL server. Okay, connect. Say here localhost. This is just a name, guys. You can give any name so that you can remember what you are going to do. And here username is root and password is also root. And the database here is, I would like to work with the Sakila database and test it. Connection successful. Say okay. Okay, another data source got added to the list. There are three data sources here. This data source for working with the QFox database. This data source for working with the Sakila database in MySQL server. This data source for working with world database in MySQL server. Like that, guys. Click on okay. Now how to change the, now if I go to this SQL ODBC query client tool, okay. Current selected database is world. If you want to change that, again say new. Okay, either you can say query with change connection also. Okay, when you say change connection, automatically this will come. You can change the database to Sakila database. So for each and every database, you have to create a data source here, right? For each and every database, you have to create it. For QFox database, I have created data source. For Sakila database, I have created another data source. For world database, again another data. This time, if you want to work with Sakila database, select this Sakila database and say okay. Okay. So what happened here, and say okay. Yeah, it got changed, guys. Okay, it got changed under tables. We'll get the tables of this Sakila database. Okay, all the things of views, tables, okay, and any other things of the Sakila database will be displayed here. Now you can perform operations on this. For example, if I say select star from actor and right click and then execute this, you see all the records from this actor table of the Sakila database will be displayed here. And you can perform any operations on this. Okay, you can write any queries on this particular table and do the stuff. Okay, the same thing that explained as part of the previous videos. So guys, so at a high level, let me conclude the thing. Let me conclude this session by saying that if you want to connect to MySQL, okay, server databases, if you want to connect to the MySQL server and access the databases which are there in this MySQL server, then you need two type of drivers. We need one type of driver is JDBC driver. Other type of driver we need is ODBC driver. Okay, there are two drivers. So where we have to use JDBC driver? If you want to connect to this MySQL server from the Java programs, let's say there are some Java programs, and from this Java programs, if you want to make a connection to this MySQL server, you need JDBC driver. At same time, we have this MySQL Workbench client tool, right? MySQL Workbench client tool. Okay, So this tool will be installed when you install MySQL Server automatically. You don't have to install it separately, right? So this MySQL Workbench client tool also internally uses. You don't have to download this JDBC driver. In case of Java programs, you have to manually download. Okay, download JDBC driver and configure the Java project with the JDBC driver. But in case of MySQL Workbench client, you don't have to download. Automatically, this tool will use JDBC driver internally for connecting to this MySQL server. Okay, you don't have to manually download. Okay, in case of MySQL Workbench. But coming to the ODBC driver. Okay, but coming to the ODBC driver, this ODBC driver is also required for connecting to the databases, accessing the databases by connecting to the MySQL server. Same operation only. But here, so which tool is using this ODBC driver for connecting to this MySQL server and accessing the database inside it? Okay, the tool that is explained in this video session, that is SQL ODBC, okay, query tool. Okay, this tool. So for this particular client tool to connect to this MySQL server and access the database, we need ODBC driver. And for this, we have to download and install. Okay, driver. Which driver? ODBC driver. We have to download and install. Without downloading and install ODBC driver, we cannot connect. But if this MySQL server is installed in your own machine, then this download and installing is not required, right? By default with MySQL server, okay, this ODBC driver is coming. Okay, in some cases what will happen is your machine will be here, some MySQL server will be here. So MySQL server will be installed in the remote machine. In your machine, MySQL will not be there. At that time, you have to manually download this ODBC driver in your machine, okay, and install it. And then only you can create the data sources for connecting to the MySQL server, which is there in the remote machine. But in this video session, MySQL server is installed in my own machine. So I was not in a need to install this ODBC driver. Without installing this ODBC driver also, I got the options to create the data sources, right? But anyhow, in this video session, I showed you how to install this ODBC driver on your own. Fine. So guys, these two drivers are the main drivers in the market. Okay, ODBC driver and JDBC driver are the two drivers in the market which are required for connecting to the MySQL server from different tools and programs. So we have to remember this ODBC driver and JDBC driver while working with the SQL. Okay, while you are working with SQL, you should have some knowledge about this JDBC driver and ODBC driver, and where exactly we use this JDBC driver and where exactly we use this ODBC driver. Okay, so this kind of basic knowledge you should have. So guys, this is all about the ODBC. So hope you understood what is ODBC and how it is different from JDBC and all. So that's it guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.